Hello and welcome to BusyWorksBeats.com. Today we're going to go over the drill style of hip hop, and we're going to start from scratch in FL Studio and create a beat from scratch. Now we're not going to use only FL Studio plugins because it takes a lot of live instrumentation that you can't find in FL Studio in particular. So we're going to use a lot of plugins like Omnisphere, Kontakt, Nexus, Hip Hop Brass by StudioLink VST. And we're going to put all these elements together and create a track in the drill style. So the first thing we need to do is set the tempo. Tempo varies, but 125 to about 140 is typical. So let's try 125 and let's hear what the rhythm sounds like. That's pretty good, 125. So first thing we want to do is actually get the drum pattern down. Now this is just a bare bones drum pattern. We're not, gonna base the whole track around this, but it's just a typical, trying to keep the energy of the track alive. So we're gonna program some kicks in here. Let's go to playlist mode. Let's call this the drums. Add these in up to 16 bars. And we're gonna create different variations as well. Because there's a certain thing about Chicago music that Young Chop started, I believe, and I don't like. So let's first get the drum pattern right. First, we wanna send everything to the mixer. So double click everything, make sure everything's green. Go to your mixer, insert one. You wanna right click, link selected channels starting from this track. Now everything's in the mixer. I know for a fact the snare gets very loud, so I want to turn it down. That's what I did that for. So now we're going to get the kick and the snare. So we're going to put the snares, since we're in double time, we're going to put the snares not where you would typically put the snare. So you would put it, a beat further. Because we're in double time. So think boom, ch, boom, 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 ch, boom. Boom, boom. That's the Chicago style. So we're going to make the clone of this. We're going to clone it. And we're going to delete the boom, boom at the end. And we're only going to have that one shot. So now we're going to hit Control Shift, highlight every other pattern, and we're going to call that pattern 2. So now we have variation in our drums. Okay, so that's the main trick. A lot of people don't add variation to their drums. It makes your beat sound really repetitive. Now in pattern 3, we're gonna change this to 8 beats per bar, and we're gonna add the hi-hat rhythm. So there's a lot of rolls that go into the hi-hat, so you can make tons of variations. I like to make at least 2 hi-hat rolls or hi-hat variations. So we're gonna fill each 2 steps and add this into the playlist so that we have a more realistic understanding of what the hi-hat is doing. First, I want to speed it up, so I'm going to left click and drag more notes. So let's right click, send it to piano roll. Here we have a lot more control. So I want to add a hi-hat roll right around here. And I want it to be kind of an awkward roll, so I'm going to go to snap to grid third steps, and I'm going to hit control U instead of doing half step rolls. That's a little too fast for me, so I'm going to actually go back to third beat and hit Control U. Now the reason why that doesn't make sense is because it was already chopped into a section. So we're going to drag it out to be one long note and then hit Control U. So now we have a little triplet section. Now we're going to clone that and we're going to add some hi-hat rolls. So we're going to go back to snap to grid, half step this time, and I'm going to add a quicker roll. Pattern 4. It's cool to add rolls in the beginning. Now what you want to do with your hi-hat rolls is make them unique. You can mess with the velocity by right-clicking and dragging the notes, or you can go here to the drop-down, change your panning of the notes so that they roll kind of from left to right. I like to do that a lot. You could even change the cutoff frequency if you want for the low pass filter, or you could do fine tuning, meaning, the pitch of the hi-hat. You can increase it. So that's what I'm going to do. So for every other pattern, again, we're control shift selecting, and we're going to change this to pattern 4. So now we have variation. We're going to lower our closed hi-hats. Now we're going to add some snare rolls. Just like we did hi-hat rolls, we're going to add snare rolls. And we have a particular snare for it, and it's a really quick decay snare. So we're going to create one snare roll, and we're just going to loop it. So the first two bars. So it's going to be very active. So it's going to be just like a hi-hat roll. Okay, so that's where we're going to have the rolls. Now you want to go into piano roll to make it more unique. So again, I like to just make sure I know where I'm going to put the rolls, drag out one long note, and then I go to, let's do third steps maybe, hit Control U. That's a little too fast probably. Let's try half steps first. And then I'm going to have that third step or third beat chop at the end. So it's going to be triplet notes. You could do the same thing. You could pan your snares. You could change the pitch, which I'm going to do here. Kind of make them go down. Not as much though, just very slightly. And then make these go up slightly. We're going to go to the mixer and just lower the velocity, the fader. Okay, so that's going to be at the end of every four bars, just a quick snare roll. So, okay, so now you know all the drum sequencing. Now we're going to get into the dark feel of the style tracks, and we're going to get into the instrumentation, which is a very, you know, key part, obviously. So let's go into a new pattern. And also, we're not going to work on the 808 yet, okay? We're going to leave the 808 for a little bit later. I forgot to add the cymbal, so let's go back to the cymbals, and we're just going to add this type of cymbal and an open hi-hat in there as well. So now we're going to tune the cymbal so it sounds, you know, better than that. So to tune the cymbal, what you need to do is either grab the fine pitch tune knob and pitch and tune it to the song. So let's go. So we're gonna lower that in the mixer and pan it. Just so now we have the general rhythm. Now we're going to get into the instrumentation. Now the instrumentation is going to be very, very, very dark. So we're going to use a lot of minor chords. And you can learn all the minor, major, and how to understand music theory at BusyWorksBeats.com. Our product, Music Theory in a Day, will teach you everything you need to know. So let's figure out what dark chords we could use. I like to play over the drum beat in the background to really get the, you know, the atmosphere right. So let's go to, let's lower this in the mixer and go back to the song, the playlist, and just hit play. I'm gonna play some chords until I get the right vibe, and then we're gonna record it. So again, you wanna use minor chords like A minor, D minor. It's a little too happy, so let's go. Do E minor. That's a little too happy. So you gotta think dark. You know, dark would be like, this is a very tense chord. So what I might do is D minor. then this tenth E chord, and then F major 7. Maybe not that happy. We're gonna do an inverted F major 7. So that's a lot to take in if you're new, I understand, but again, we explain it and teach you how to do it and understand music very easily at busyworksbeats.com and Music Theory in a Day. So anyway, let's record these chords. Now, I recorded very long because I want to manipulate the chords. So I recorded that not in the real way I'm going to use the chords. I know that might baffle some people, but I did that for a reason. So let's hit Control A, Alt Q to quantize. And I don't know what I just did, but I just did something. So let's slide this over to fit. Hit Alt Q one more time. And basically, I want this to be the filler chord. I don't want it to last so long. So we're gonna have D minor, and then we're gonna have the last two chords kind of play out. I just need to figure out where I want the chords to switch. So we're gonna have them on the last two. So it's going bum bum, and let's slide this over. I think that's the same chord, let me make sure. Okay, so now we're gonna hit Control A again, Alt Q, Alt L this time to get rid of, to fix the lengths of the chords. Now to make the sound very, you know, weird or more eerie, we're gonna take the top chords and hit Control Up to transpose them up an octave to make them very eerie. We're gonna push the choir to the back. We don't want it to overwhelm the track. We're gonna copy and make a new pattern and paste that into the piano. And now we're gonna have more, you know, bottom tonality to it. So let's call this chord, well, let's call this the choir, piano chords. And we're gonna bring in the choir more as a supportive section. So maybe in the, we're gonna call this like the chorus area. Let's go to song mode. And I flipped it. So this is, where are we at? This should be pattern 8, not pattern 7. So let's highlight those, select source, pattern 8. This is the piano. And we're gonna lower it. So this is a more musical drill, probably more musically accurate instead of so much dissonance. Now we're getting into some underruns. I'm going to fix the audio really quickly. Okay, now we still have much more to go, like the brass, the sub bass, the 808. There's a lot more to go. So right now we're going to add some gunshot percussion just to kind of, you know, top off our, you know, the drum sequence. So we have that gunshot, or we have this one. Whoops. I like this one better. But I'm going to work with the envelope a little bit more, give it a quick decay. And I'm going to take out that little delay here. Whatever that little thing in the beginning is, we're going to drag this back into the sampler. So it's a direct gunshot rather than a slow gunshot. And okay, so we're gonna give that a little bit of reverb to make it sound cooler. So Fruity Reverb 2, you don't have to use the top line reverbs. Now, in this case, I would change it to a drum room. Lower the bass level, maybe use a low cut. You don't want it to sound like a video game, but you know, I mean like a, you know, not a real video game, not like Call of Duty. There we go. So the question is, where do we add the gunshot? We're going to add it at the end here. Let's create a new track. Call this the Gun FX, and let's add that in. Pattern 9. So let's see. So that's, you know, just something to, you know, add to the feeling of the track a little bit more. All right. Where were we at? So the brass. So let's get onto the brass. The brass, all we're going to do is play the same chords, but we're going to add a rhythm to them. Now, a quick way to just add a rhythm to the brass is to copy the chord structure. Hit Control C, find a new pattern, and copy it into the brass. Now, I'm going to use the Hip Hop Brass XL from StudioLink VST. They have some good brass patches. We're going to lower this fader. Now, I don't want the brass to play long notes. I want it to play a rhythm. That's the whole point. So what I want to do is go into the brass. And to create a rhythm, we're going to use the slice tool here. So grab the slice tool at the top. And we're going to lower the brass. It's very rich. So I want to go bam, 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 da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da. So you have to slice down. And make sure you're on half steps so you have a better view. And now we're going to chop into third. So you want to go to third step. Zoom in so you can see. And we're going to chop this into threes. Because if you don't get the right measurements, you're going to mess it up. So now you hear that. Now I'm going to fix the lengths of the notes so they're not so long. But for now, I'm just going to copy, delete that, and paste. So I don't have to chop again. And then I'm going to paste it again. Now for these notes, a quick way to fix the length is just highlight all the notes, go to snap to grid, step, make sure you're on step, go to the piano roll options, edit, and discard lengths. Now I have to come up with a pattern that I want to hear up here. I'm not really sure yet. Maybe triplets. So I want it to be triplets. Now I'm going to highlight these since it's, you know, since the notes are, what I'm going to do is drag this out first, grab the slice tool and right click, and that will delete the excess. Now I'm going to highlight the notes and I'm going to go to snap to grid, third beat, and now I'm going to hit Control U, and that should do what I want it to do. It's too fast, so I want it to go, do that again. Dun, 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 dun. I guess that's what I wanted. So again, let's go to snap to grid, step, go to edit, discard lengths. That way you have. That might be too much movement, so you can delete some notes if you don't want them. Maybe 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. So let's delete every other note. It just seems too fast for me. So I'm hitting Control Shift and I'm highlighting the notes and we're going to hit delete. Now remember, we transposed the octave. So now we're going to highlight this high octave and we're going to hit Control Down. Because we want the brass to fill that octave rather than, you know, mess with the piano and choir. What I'm going to do for the brass is give it a little attack. If that doesn't sound all right, we're just going to go back to. Okay, so what we're going to do is copy this brass and paste it into the brass that we have from Kontakt under the Symphobia 2 library. And this has a very orchestral, rich brass, and I think it has strings involved as well. So you can see that. And I clicked on something. So let's, it's very, you know, orchestral. So we're going to lower this first off. Let's solo it. You can hear strings and brass with this one. Okay, so now we're going to move on to pattern 11. We're going to add some tremolo strings for the really eerie tension for the track. So we're going to figure out what note is going to add the tension. And we're going to go to the Nexus to add like a bell or something, maybe. Or something from Nexus. You know, there really isn't a drilled beat unless you use Nexus. Notice we didn't even add the 808 yet, so we have a lot more to go. So whatever that note is works. So D, we're gonna play D for the tension note, and we're gonna play high D. We might even take it up an octave or play octaves, meaning play two octaves at once, so, or that might work. So we're gonna pan that to the left. We're gonna add that string tremolo at the end there. Okay, the note's too long, so what we're gonna do is slide it over here and cut it down to half size. We're gonna use Nexus for like the melodic synth, I guess. And I'm gonna use the gunshot on the down. So we're gonna make a new pattern, add the gunshot. I wanna pitch this gunshot up so it's like, has a little too much bass. Maybe I can just go to pattern 5, parametric EQ 2, cut out some low end. There we go. Because I like the length of this drum. I mean, this gun shot effect. So let's see what that sounds like. There we go. All right, now we're gonna move into the 808. Okay, so firstly, I wanna mention that I'm gonna use the 808 for part of the song and then a sub bass patch for the other part to add a lot of tension. So the 808, we first need to tune it. You wanna right click, go to edit, go to ABC regions, detect pitch regions. So we're in F sharp. Click back on miscellaneous and you wanna right click F sharp. If you mess up, hit reset. Make sure you right click whatever that note says. So F sharp. So now when we play the keyboard, it'll play the correct notes for the 808. First, we just need to come up with a pattern for the 808. We're not worried about the notation yet. Let's put the 808 up here so we can find it. And let's see, 808. All right, so I'm gonna actually right click, send it to piano roll. So it's gonna be in D. And I like to just, you know, work in the piano roll because it's a lot easier to add notation. Now we're gonna hit control up to send it up an octave. Very simple 808 pattern so far, nothing spectacular. We're just going to lower it in the mixer because it's a little loud. So we're going to clone this pattern and we're going to add more movement. Again, you want to have like two versions of any drum pattern so it doesn't get repetitive. So we're going to take this to pattern 14 and here's where we're going to add a little more movement to the 808. So we're going to work with triple notes. So we're going to go to snap to grid, third steps. I'm going to highlight this so we don't have to keep listening to the first two bars. A lot of movement here with the 808. Now when you go up with the 808, you want to make sure you come down, you know, pretty quickly. So whenever you go up, you want to make sure you come down eventually. You don't want to have a lingering up note. If you want your 808 to slide a little bit more, you want to go to your sampler, miscellaneous tab, activate portamento and mono, and increase your slide a little bit. So you get a little more. So let's hear what that sounds like in the mix. So for the chorus section, we're going to add a little distortion automation. So we're going to put on the 808. We're going to put a plugin. I like to use Decimort. So we're just going to use Decimort. We're going to right click, create automation clip, and we're going to lower all our bars and just have it slowly come in about 5% or whatever, and then go back down to nothing over here. So just very subtle distortion. You don't want it to be obvious. Going to add to the aggression of the track. All right, I have a couple more elements I thought I was gonna add, like this kind of weird sample. So we're gonna add that. And what I'm gonna do too is add that portamento and mono slide. So it's a very weird, and I'm also gonna, don't worry about what I'm doing, but under the volume, we're gonna increase the attack a little bit. So it's a little more smooth. I want it to be kind of a weird slide. And we're gonna create like a melodic support bed. So this is more advanced. You know, it's just to make the mood more textured. So that's what we're doing it for. Let's call this, what did I call it? Melodic bed. So, okay, so I'm gonna go to piano roll. I'm gonna do a lot of sliding and a lot of weird stuff. Now also I'm gonna add, I'm gonna make sure I'm on half steps. Okay, great. I'm gonna lower this length. I'm gonna double click it and make it a slide note. Make it go up. And make that one go down. So, you know, it's more advanced stuff, but it's just gonna add texture to the background. We're gonna have that play in the background. Now remember, when you do this type of stuff, you want to always have variation. You don't want it to sound repetitive all the time, you know. So for these, we're going to create a new pattern, and we're going to clone this and change all these to pattern 16. So we have like the melodic bed kind of wrap up. So we're going to go down, 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 down. I don't know how low it's gonna go, so let's hear. This time we're gonna stretch these out. Okay, so it's very, you know, we're adding these longer slides so that it has like a portamento pitch effect. So that's very, you know, esoteric type stuff there. Also, there we go. So that's going to be the second portion. Now we're not going to have it back to back because that takes away from the whole repetitiveness of this type of this genre. So we're going to have those run three in a row and then have that variation at the end. So what I want to do for the chorus, I want to have these actually have a higher octave play in the background. So what I'm going to do is make these unique. I'm going to make that unique and then make that unique. And then I'm going to delete the in-between. Okay, so I'm going to go to Edit and I'm going to hit Control A, Control C, and then Control Up. Let's hear what this sounds like. So I just want a higher octave of what we just did. Same thing here, edit, hit Control A, Control Up. And I'm gonna have those two play underneath of the original melodic bit. So this might be a little much for, you know, beginners and intermediate, but you know, this is what separates you from, you know, everybody else. Let's hear that in context. Now what we need to do, what I did was I didn't make the sample unique, so it doesn't know to play only one. So I need to clone this and actually cut and paste into the new sample, as well as this sample here, edit, pattern, and Control X, Control V into the new sample so that they don't overlap. Now let's get into Nexus, and we're just going to pick a synth, something that sounds very Nexus like. Let's go to dance leads. I don't even know what to pick. I don't use Nexus a lot. Let's try Cheesy Madness and let's lower that in the mixer. Whoops. We're going to pan that to the left. We're going to play a high octave something. It's going to be very repetitive, whatever it is. All right, let's hear it. So that's what the melody is going to be. Now notice how all these elements together kind of get chaotic. So we have to lower the velocity of some of these, or the fader for some of these. So that's the pattern for Nexus. Now we have to quantize the notes. So we're going to hit Control A, slide everything over. To get it on the grid, hit Control A, Alt Q. Now we want to define length for this as well, so we're going to go to Snap to Grid, Step Mode, Edit under the thing, Discard Lengths. So that's the melody per se. But again, there's so much going on, it might not be beneficial to have it so up in the front of our you know, in the front. So let's hear it. Because this kind of winding pitch kind of takes away. So I'm gonna play the beat about two times through, and we're just gonna match it up with the picture here to make sure everything's, you know, good. All right, so now you have it, the drill style genre. We'll probably post this beat to YouTube eventually. So again, to understand all this stuff, if you want to understand, you know, the music behind everything, you really want to grab Music Theory in a Day from BusyWorksBeats.com. You'll understand the chords and the eerie chords and all that type of stuff. You want to grab the X kit from BusyWorksBeats.com. It has a lot of the sounds and the drums that we use today. I also forgot where to make the sub bass, but whatever. The beat actually sounds fair with the 808. Again, a lot of these sounds are from the X kit, busyworksbeats.com. And if you want to learn music theory, again, Music Theory in a Day from busyworksbeats.com. And if you really want to learn how to mix your 808s properly, you want to grab 808 Science from busyworksbeats.com as well. All right. You can, and also check out our beats formulas and the ultimate producer bundle. A lot of stuff for you, busyworksbeats.com. And if you want to mix this down for the radio and get it to sound professional, you want to check out How to Mix Beats Easily. And we have an advanced course as well, teaching a lot of secret stuff. So thanks for watching today. It's BusyWorksBeats.com.